Ooh, yeah, leader on the night, the Macho Man will be the human torpedo and destroy the Avalanche!
Tonight's the night, Savage! You got the 500-pound Avalanche coming straight for you!
Thinking, then in a little while, Avalanche, you need a little excitement. Step into the Macho Man. I'm gonna get you and beat you, yeah!
As promised, Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel visited this week by Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage, and he said you need to see what happened. Our cameras were there, and here's exactly what happened.
Wrestling fans, we told you at the top of the program today that WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan and Randy Macho Man Savage came to me with a request that was so startling that I felt that you, the fans, should share and see it. And at this time, in my office, I have with me Randy Macho Man Savage,
right,
world champion, Hulk Hogan.
You know, after the last 20 minutes, Bachman, you gotta say that the Macho Man and Hulk Hogan don't have a request. We've got a pretty strong case. You know, the Hulkamaniacs are demanding this thing, brother. Ric Flair was in my face in Baltimore, man. He put Dave Sullivan in the hospital. And, oh, of course, it uncensored. We knew he'd be hovering around the ring, man. But he's completely out of line, isn't he, Macho Man?
Let's face it, Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel. You lost control of the situation. You're powerless at this point, and things are out of control already. So why don't we go to complete mental insanity, get him reinstated, and that's the only way you'll ever gain power again. He dressed in drag. What else will he do?
Well, you know, he's totally out of control, brother. And now that we know that he's been barred from the buildings, that he can't come to any WCW matches, that's a bunch of bull, brother. We want Ric Flair back in the ring.
Yes!
It's a demand from Macho Man and the Hulkamaniacs. That's the only way we can get our hands on him. So now that you told us that you can't do anything about it, now that you've got to go to the executive committee, brother, case in point, the facts are this. He was in our face in Baltimore. Sullivan went to the hospital. Uncensored, he was out of control, and it's going to go on and on and on. We want him in the ring, brother. Jimmy Hart's a man, 24 hours a day.
Get in touch with Hart.
Get it done.
Let me promise you this, that there will be a vote next week by the executive board, and according to that vote is the way we will go. I will take your request. They will hear it. They will feel it. They will see it.
Well, you've got our number. Please call us as soon as you can.
We want to know what happens. Get it done, Bockwinkel.
Whatever it takes.
You've got it. Well, Randy.
Later in the show, Savage, that's going to be like deja vu. You get it. The Avalanche. You are finished.
Your time is up, the Avalanche, yeah. Let's see what you got. It's time to feel the wrath. The Macho Man.
Hands up, Savage. Your insurance better be paid up, because you're going straight to the hospital after I give you the Avalanche!
We are back with you on Saturday night, and fans, things are really heating up here in WCW. The rumor mill, as I said earlier, smoking again. Three very prominent wrestling superstars are allegedly on their way to WCW. If these three men show up, it will be the blockbuster of the year. There's only one man who knows it, and that's Mean Gene Okerlund. Call him tonight on the Wrestling Hotline at 1-900-909-9900, $1.49 a minute. And fans, don't forget the main event tomorrow night, 6:05 Eastern Time. Join us right here on TBS as you will see in the big main event, Sting against Butcher. That's all coming up tomorrow night here
wait
on...
Wait a minute, Tony.
All right, come
tell
in.
Tell me something right now. If you know there's somebody coming to WCW, you know there's three stars coming here. I got to know. Tell me who it is.
I don't know who it is.
Oh, you know who it is.
No, I don't.
You and Orkland know everything.
Call Gene tonight on the
hotline.
I
don't want to call Gene. I want to know. I need the scoop. Give me the scoop. I'll give you $5 to give me the scoop. I'll take you to dinner. I'll go through the big window with the car. No. Come on. Give me. Just tell me. I got to know this scoop.
Call Gene tonight on the hotline.
Wait a minute.
Let's go to the ring.
You knew,
leave me alone.
I know. You know. You know.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, at over 500 pounds, from Mount Everett, Washington, Avalanche!
Savage is history!
Very simply put, he says, Savage is history. It's Avalanche. He and the Macho Man in our big main event. When we come back here on WCW Saturday Night, the entrance of the Macho Man and the entire match. Stay with us, fans.
It's a 500-pound Avalanche.
Monica, I love you.
Romance on the Rocks, Brad.
Chuck Woolery?
Why don't you tell us what happened?
Nothing. I dialed zero to call a collect.
And what should you have done?
Dialed 1-800-COLLECT and saved us some cash?
Would have been my move. Want to try again?
1-800-COLLECT. Yo, Chuck, do you mind?
Today's harder working engines need Castrol GTX, the motor oil that provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because if your oil breaks down, what's next? Castrol GTX, engineered for greater protection against breakdown.
Magneto has arrived. In X-Men 2, play the most mutant heroes, including Magneto. Only on Sega Genesis.
This was our career bust. This is what, $100 million?
Gone.
Two cops.
Just do what you do, only faster.
Two partners.
Can you stay focused? What are you talking about? I'm focused.
Too close to the edge.
You ain't with the bad guys now. You with the cops.
Martin Lawrence, Will Smith.
You know, you drive almost slow enough to drive Miss Daisy.
Bad Boys, What You Gonna Do? Rated R. At theaters April 7th.
Jim, it's a
time
pressure
out.
Cooker down here.
Okay, okay.
These are the kind of decisions coaches live
for. Come on, coach. You got to make a call.
All right. Well, let's go for two.
Just give me a second.
While we're young, please.
Got to be three, man.
Come on.
Okay, here's what we're going with. Pepperoni, mushroom, and sausage.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, wait.
And peppers.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Any toppings, you make the call. $8.99 gets you any or all of your favorite toppings and a medium hand-tossed pizza.
I would have gone for the ham and onion.
Worried you might have termites? Call 1-800-TERMINEX to know for sure.
Where's that number?
Nobody offers a better guarantee. Even if you've misplaced our number, just remember, 1-800-TERMINEX. Call now.
Kids go for what kids love. And moms choose great-tasting Flintstones nearly 3-to-1 over any other brand. Have your kids had their Flintstones today?
People love good food, flavored with garlic, onions, and spices. But it happens, bad breath. I can eat what I want because of Breath Assure, the internal breath freshener. Gargles, sprays, and gums, nah, mini cover-ups. All natural Breath Assure is long-lasting. Swallow a few of these powerful capsules that work from the inside. Be sure. Breath Assure.
To order Breath Assure for $19.95, call 800-257-1234. Call now, that's 800-257-1234.
Next on TBS, you don't just kidnap the Duke's kinfolk and get away with it. John Wayne is Big Jake. Coming up next on TBS.
WCW Saturday Night has been brought to you by Payday Candy Bar. Payday's almost totally nuts.
And ladies and gentlemen, the opponent in this main event contest from Sarasota, Florida. Weighing 235.
Oh, you better get out of there, Gary. The Macho Man has hit the ring, and he's going to pick up where they left off last Sunday, Brain. They didn't get the issue settled thanks to Ric Flair being dressed as a lady, and now here they go.
I don't understand, Savage. Why anybody with bolts in the dressing room at a couple hundred miles an hour and charge into a man weighing 500 pounds? But that's the way Savage is. He's too tough to know when he's had it.
Knee to the back. He rolls Avalanche up one.
How many people could say they rolled up a 517-pound man, but that stopped Savage short right there.
Well, Savage has so much intestinal fortitude, and he's got so much desire. But Avalanche is just 500 pounds, Tony.
Belly to belly, and he doesn't even want to cover it. Maybe a mistake here.
Maybe a mistake. You got a chance to pin the Macho Man. You better take it.
Absolutely.
He'll come back to bite you in the forehead in a minute.
The Macho Man slowly getting to his feet. And a drop kick. It was a 500-pound drop kick. Incredible.
And Savage took that one on the back of the arm and hit his rope. Back of his arm hit the rope, so it was a steel cable. He could have torn his shoulder out.
The Macho Man is in trouble. And he's right in front of us here. In our main event here on Saturday night. Oh, my.
Savage is down, and he can't get up. Look, there's one of the little critters trying to put the boots to Savage.
Back in the ring. Savage dazed. A pickup. And a slam.
Don't waste your time, Avalanche.
Well, he's enjoying this now in front of millions of people watching Saturday night here on TBS Best.
You can't do that with Savage. You can't give him room to breathe.
You're right, Savage. Pick up. Clothesline. Savage going to the top. The Macho Man on target.
You know, the Savage goes right for the pin.
And a big kick out.
Avalanche is a long way from being pinned.
You're not kidding, he is.
That won't work.
Watch him go for it again. That's what kind of competitor he is. The Macho Man with that intensity that we had seen in past weeks. He has been like a man possessed here, like a man on a mission. You heard what he said to Nick Bockwinkel earlier. He said a man's got to do what a man's got to do.
And he'll do anything.
That's right.
Well, there's one thing about Savage, you know, I'll tell you about this guy. If you nail him over the head with a chair, he'll say, that's okay. Now I know how the game's played. You better watch out next time. He'll hit you with a whole row of chairs.
Truly one of the greatest competitors this sport's ever seen. And right now, though, with an array of headbutts to the chest, the Macho Man finds himself in dire straits here against 516, maybe 17 pounds.
Yeah, make a difference out of a pound.
Yeah, I know.
Guys, 570 pounds. You're going to quibble for a pound.
Not me. I'm not going to quibble at all with this guy. Avalanche is a force in WCW, one of the top superstars. And he is leveling Savage right now. One, two, and Savage got out of it.
Very nonchalant cover. You're going to cover Savage, you got to be on him.
Oh. Walked across the chest. If you joined us at Uncensored last Sunday, you know that their match kind of curtailed thanks to Ric Flair dressed up as a lady coming in. That, of course, was the force behind Savage joining Hogan in Commissioner Bockwinkel's office this week, as we saw earlier. Wanting Flair in the ring. The vote will come next week.
But you got to admit, he was the prettiest woman in Tupelo.
I wouldn't say that at all. You might.
Avalanche could be the prettiest woman in Tupelo, the way he looks.
Brain.
But Savage won't be too pretty when he's done with him.
With ease, picking up Savage. Big power slam.
Put a load of groceries in the trunk.
Hooks a leg. Two. Did not have the lateral press across the shoulders, though. And that enabled Savage to get up. Uh-oh, Avalanche.
Just hit him with the wrist right alongside of the neck.
We do understand also, fans, there are rumors abounding.
Rumors?
About Ric Flair.
What kind of rumors?
Well, there's a vote next week whether he can get reinstated or not. But there's rumors that he may purchase time on this television program himself next week.
Well, he's got the money, he's got the connections, and he is Ric Flair. I wouldn't put anything past him.
Last week, Commissioner Bockwinkel said you'll never be on a WCW television program again, nor in an arena. You're out of here, and Flair is talking through his lawyers about buying time and having his own segment on the program next week. We will bring you that if it happens.
But don't forget, Nick can make a lot of rules, and he can make a lot of proclamations, this and that. He still has a board of people he has to answer to.
I know that. But money's money. Double axe handle blow. It staggered the big giant.
Flair's got the coin, believe me.
Here he goes again. Oh, my goodness. He got the knee to the midsection, and Savage goes down hard.
Well, I'll tell you, if I was Avalanche, I'd slam Savage maybe seven or eight times, and I'd hold on to him. I'd drive my weight right into his, right through that mat. I'd pin him in that corner. I wouldn't let him breathe for 1 minute. That's how you have to beat Savage. You just have to glom him.
That's what's happening here. The force of 500-plus pounds, pulling, pushing down on the foot, the top rope. for extra outer leverage.
Pick Savage up and climb to the top rope with him and just dive to the cement floor. That's what I would do.
That's what you could injure yourself that way.
Okay, then I'll have you do it.
Pick, that sounds more like the brain we know.
I don't want to get hurt because of Savage.
A pickup and slung him down. Savage pulling himself up. Look at this.
As tough as he is, he can be beaten. He's a human being.
Of course.
He's got blood, sweat, and bones. I think Avalanche is kind of miffed that he can't put this man away.
Well, I think he's more than that right now. I think he's been beaten around quite a bit here by a 500-pound man. I don't know if he's thinking at all, just reacting, instinct. How can you think about a strategy when that guy is pounding on you? You just have to do whatever you can. Instinct, like right here, a foot to the chest.
He won't go down, will he?
No, he won't. Head first to the turnbuckle.
Boy, Savage just pulled some hair out of his head, too.
Oh, boy, Savage goes down hard again.
You see the handful of hair come out of the head of Avalanche?
Avalanche and Savage with a couple of gut shots. Didn't even faze him. Now he goes the head. That one did. That one staggered him to the corner.
See, Savage knows he's looking for air right now. So he's going to try to cut off all the air to Avalanche as quick as he can.
Macho Madness trying to get going here. And Avalanche is almost down. Here he goes. He went down. He covers him. One, two.
Got the ropes. He's got the ropes.
Hand on the rope, you're right, and I believe Macho was also across the ropes as well.
Now, you notice he didn't try to throw Savage off. He tried to grab the ropes. Maybe he is out of gas.
One, two, no, he kicked out that time.
But he didn't shove him off like he did a couple of minutes ago.
Absolutely not. Savage got him. Savage with a front chancery, and that enables the Avalanche to drive him back to a neutral corner. The chant of Macho for the capacity crowd as always here at our arena.
See, now he should follow up and just drive into the corner. What an intelligent looking kid, huh? Parents told him to put his socks on, he put a hat on.
A whip in the corner.
Oh!
Nick Patrick asked the Macho Man if he wanted to continue. He got a nod that time. He moved. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, moved out of the way.
The Savage is not in a good position. You don't want to be flat on your back with that man standing.
He moved again. The Macho Man kicking Avalanche.
Boy, just when you think you got Savage beat, he comes back to beat you. He's so quick. He's got so much fight left in him.
To the eyes of the big man.
About his fourth or fifth time going up top.
Uh-oh, he's there to meet him. This doesn't look good for Savage, but he's fighting. He's in a tough spot.
Uh-oh.
And he's in a tougher spot now.
It's the beginning of the end right here.
Oh, there it is.
Macho Madness is stopped.
You may be right, Brain.
Uh-oh. Second floor.
The side of a mountain coming down on nowhere.
An eyelash. He got out of the way in an eyelash.
Elbow on the back of the head.
Avalanche is hurt.
He elbowed him on the back of the head. He's going up top, and here comes Kevin Sullivan. Here comes Butcher. Kevin trying to pull the Avalanche out. Butcher trying to pull Savage. Butcher goes down. Kevin can't move him.
Does he have it?
One, two,
he can't believe this. I do not believe this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Macho Man, Randy Savage.
The Macho Man gets the win. The three faces of fear try to help Avalanche. They're stuck on the outside. They seem to be here without any game plan at all. Look at them.
Well, I'll tell you, Savage got a 1-2-3 victory over Avalanche, and he got by all three faces of fear. How does he do it?
They're gonna go get him. It's basically a three-on-one.
you better put the wagons in a circle.
Sting has come out. And there they go. The three faces of fear looking a little disoriented here.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage. Kevin Sullivan trying to get the Avalanche on his feet. Savage coming off that top rope. That big elbow right to the back. For the one, for the two, and for the three, I do not believe it. Tony Schiavone is going to be talking to the Stinger and the man that's unbelievable, the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah. The three faces of fear attack again. Sting comes in to help out. I tell you what, great win for the Macho Man. Been a busy week for you. Going to see the Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel earlier in the week, and I know you got a lot on your mind.
First things first. This guy over to my left, this guy right here. I didn't know you when I came to the WCW, man. Put you under the microscope. Heard other people talk about you. Man, you're cool, brother. Big time! Thank you!
Plain and simple, the only thing I gotta say about that is, ooh, yeah, dig it! Yeah. Macho Man, I'm always there for you. Bottom line, woo!
Along those same lines, business at hand. The Nature Boy, priority one. Obviously, Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel is powerless. Yeah, you are, brother. And the WCW is being turned upside down. My plan is to put the WCW in a spin and reinstate the Nature Boy Ric Flair so people like the Stinger,
yes,
and the Monster Maniacs can take Ric Flair and drive him out the way we know how. Oh, yeah.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, and Sting, and a great win for the Macho Man here on Saturday Night. Fantastic.